Now, from the makers of Coldwater Omo,
Mother, John Steed and Emma Peel's boss, had handed them a most curious case. In the United States, three top-flight ear, nose, and throat specialists had all died sudden and mysterious deaths. When in London, Ralph Camrose, a Harley Street specialist, also dies of an unknown disease, the coincidence is thought to be too strong. While Steed examined the dead man's consulting rooms, Emma Peel decided to do a little checking up with other well-known physicians. She was waiting to interview Dr. Padley of Padley, Seaton and Herrick when there came the sound of violent sneezing from his office. Seconds later, the door was flung open. Padley, clearly suffering from some form of seizure, staggered into the room and collapsed. By the time Mrs. Peel had reached him, Padley was dead. She knelt by the body and took an empty envelope from his lifeless hand.
The Avengers.
John Steed and Emma Peel, The Avengers.
Episode 2 of this story, in which John Steed and Emma Peel find out more evidence which is not to be sneezed at. Steed and Emma Peel had a date for lunch. It could hardly be thought of as a celebration luncheon. They certainly had nothing to be happy about. Mrs. Peel had brought the news of Padley's death, and Steed could throw no light on the mystery of Ralph Camrose's early demise. All they did have were two cream envelopes. They lay together on the tablecloth alongside the gin and tonics.
Snap.
Not quite.
Well, you could have fooled me. They're identical. Just the name and address different. No postmark over the stamp on either of them. Both empty.
Different typewriters.
How can you tell?
Now, this one had its L's misaligned.
You're a disappointment, Steed. I thought we had a clue.
Ah, but we have.
What?
The envelopes themselves. They're identical enough.
Don't tell me. They're made of antique lay, deckle-edged vellum produced from Manitoban rag pulp.
Well, naturally. But I think we ought to have it confirmed by an expert, don't you?
Well, if it'll make you feel better.
It would make me feel better if you'd stick close to Seaton and Herrick. If we lose any more ear, nose and throat men, Mother will be very cross.
I see. So after lunch, I go back to protecting the medical profession while you go out on a paper chase. Is that right?
Something like that. I don't think I'll have to chase very far. Maidwell and Pugh.
I beg your pardon?
High-class manufacturers of discreet notepaper for the aristocracy. By appointment. Cheers.
Cheers, Steve.
Some few hours after that, Steed presented himself at the warehouse of Maidwell and Pugh. There was certainly plenty of paper about. Steed wandered around, feeling the texture of some of the sheets. A fuzzy little man in a pince-nez and white coat appeared from behind a counter.
Maidwell is the name. Can I help you?
John Steed. I was just browsing. I'm interested in the papers.
Well, the one you have in your hand. Beautiful, is it not? Just like velvet.
Ah, you took the words right out of my mouth.
That's our twin ply. Very popular with the aristocracy. The Countess Pen never uses anything else.
That's so. Very appropriate. However, being a gentleman so far without a title...
I quite understand, sir. May I suggest as an interim measure, a discreet monogram embossed on our unique tissue-lined parchment?
You may indeed.
I thought I detected a man of discernment.
Thank you.
How much may I put you down for, sir? A quire? Two quires? Kareem?
Oh, at the very least. Tell me something. I hope you won't consider this an insult, but is this one of your lines?
Steed produced one of the envelopes from luncheon.
I regret to say it is. It's really very, very embarrassing. I must confess our cream wove bond.
Extraordinary. A firm of your reputation.
I know. I'm very well aware of that, sir. It was only saying to Mr. Pugh the other day we ought to discontinue it.
But Mr. Pugh disapproved?
Yes, it's our big moneymaker. It was a low cost to make bulk buying a more attractive proposition.
So it's fairly common?
In every sense of the word, sir. As a matter of fact, something pretty uncommon happened with this stock about 2 months ago.
Really?
Yes. Someone bought 10,000 of those Creamwove bond envelopes.
And no paper?
How did you guess, sir?
That would be telling. Is it possible for you to tell me more of this strange transaction, Mr. Madewell?
Well, I suppose there can be no harm in it. I have to look it up in the ledger. Would you step this way, Mr.
Steed?
Yes, please. Now, where would it be? yes, this should be it. Yes, here we are, sir. 10,000 cream wove bond envelopes delivered on the 13th of April to the Anastasia Nursing Academy.
For what?
The Anastasia Nursing Academy. Thought it a bit odd at the time. What would a nursing academy want with 10,000 envelopes?
The board at the reception of Padley, Seaton and Herrick now read Mr. Seaton in, Mr. Herrick out, and of course Mr. Padley permanently out. Emma Peel had lost no time after lunch. This time she didn't wait in the reception room, but insisted upon seeing Mr. Seaton straight away.
I must confess, Mrs. Peel, that although this is my line of country, I've never come across anything like it before.
No trace of gas or drugs?
No, none.
And yet Mr. Padley seemed to be struggling for breath just before he died.
That's what amazes me. According to what you tell me, he had all the symptoms of acute asphyxiation.
And as his partner, you would know if there was anything wrong with his lungs?
We were not only partners, we were very close friends, Mrs. Peel. We've known each other for years. Why, we were students together. We worked for allergy research together, and if there was anything medically the matter with him, he would certainly have consulted me. The post. Place it down there on the desk, please, Miss Drew.
Yes, Mr. Seaton.
A healthy man apparently chokes to death in a large, airy room. It's unbelievable. Perhaps the autopsy may tell us. Might be a report here in the post.
Just a moment, Doctor.
I beg your pardon, Mrs. Pugh.
It seems there's nothing more deadly than the mail. Excuse me, this may appear rude, but there could be a special envelope. No. No.
Oh, you people are so melodramatic.
I'm sorry. Tell me, Mr. Seaton, just before Mr. Padley died, I heard the sound of violent sneezing coming from his room. The receptionist heard it too, remarked on him having caught a sudden cold. It was violent sneezing. What do you make of that?
Well, I really can't see that it can have any relevance to poor Henry's death. It seems to me he suffered some sort of gigantic muscular spasm which cut the air off from his lungs.
Collar too tight?
All his shirts were handmade. He was a meticulous man who never wore anything that didn't fit perfectly. Excuse me. Seaton? Yes. Yes, Lord Nightingale's x-rays. Yes, I'll see to them immediately. Thank you. Will you excuse me, Mrs. Peel? I shan't be very long. It is rather important.
Yes, of course.
Seaton left the office, leaving the door open. Mrs. Peel gazed at the mound of letters on the desk with a sense of disappointment. Out in the street, a Rolls-Royce drew up silently to the curbside. A familiar figure of a postman climbed out and slipped an envelope under the door. It was just very unfortunate that Seaton, having collected his x-rays, was crossing back to his consulting room at exactly that moment. Curious, he bent down, picked up the envelope, and seeing it was addressed to him, began to open it. Emma Peel heard the dreaded sneezing and darted out of the office. One look at Seaton's contorted face and the torn envelope in his hand told her everything she wanted to know. Mrs. Peel rushed to the front door and threw it open wide. The figure of the postman was climbing into the back of the rolls. The sight was so extraordinary that Mrs. Peel knew this was it. She ran to where her own car was parked, a few yards away.
First time in a long time I've had to tail a Rolls Royce, but here goes.
The Rolls swung its way quietly out of London, heading for the wooded countryside of Buckinghamshire. Emma Peel, playing all the tricks she could think of to keep inconspicuous and at the same time not lose her quarry, followed a discreet distance behind. In the Rolls, Priest, for that was the postman's name, picked up the speaking tube to talk to his chauffeur.
We seem to have a visitor, Dexter.
So I've observed, sir.
An uninvited guest. Think you can do something about it, Dexter?
I rather think so, sir. There's a crossroad a short way ahead. 5 alternative roads. Should be easy.
Good. I leave it to you.
When Emma Peel arrived at the crossroads some minutes later, there was no sign of the Rolls, and the 5 roads were all empty. Mrs. Peel, exasperated, knew she'd failed. She turned the car and headed back to London. The Rolls, hidden under some trees, remained for a while.
You got the number?
Yes, sir.
Good. I want to find out who she is.
And then deal with her, sir?
Exactly. Carry on, Dexter.
Listen every evening, Monday to Friday, to John Steed and Emma Peel, The Avengers. Brought to you by the makers of Coldwater Omo.